Hi friends, welcome to Java Coding Interview Questions and Answers. So myself Sandeep, in this video we are going to see how to add two strings in Java. For example, the input is like this. Okay, string a equal to 111. Okay, and string b equal to 222. Okay, the output should be 333. Okay, so how do we add this? So how to add when two strings are given, how do you give the output? How do you add two strings? So the thing is, by the end of this program you will be able to learn how to convert string to integer and integer to string. Okay, so let's start the program. So given the program is like this, the requirement is like this, assume that always the string a and string b are equal, then only we'll be doing this. Okay, otherwise we'll ignore. So let's write the program. So I'm creating a new class. Some strings, and inside that I am creating a main method. So let's create a string str or string s1 equal to 111 and string s2 equal to 222. Okay, so now we'll see how to convert string to integer. So we have a method called integer dot parse int, so where we pass string which will return the integer. We have a method called parseInt. What it does? It will return integer. So if you see, int java.lang.integer.parseInt throws number format exception. So it parses the string argument as a signed decimal integer. The characters in the string must all be decimal digits, except that the first character may be an ASCII minus to indicate a negative value, or an ASCII plus sign to indicate a positive value. So all the numbers should be digits in order to use this parseInt. If one of the digit is like string, other value, okay, what we'll get? We'll get a number format exception. So make sure it all contains the numbers. So the return type is int, the integer value represented by the argument in the decimal. So we get number format exception if the string does not contain a parsable integer. That means if the string, suppose if it is like this, okay, and if you are trying to do integer dot parse int of s1, we'll get a number format exception. Why? Because we are not having number here. Okay, and then integer dot parse int of s2. And just say int sum equal to. So whatever the value it is returning, we are storing it in the sum. Sys out sum. Let's run the program and see the output. So if you see, it is 333. Now let's change the inputs. So now what should be the output? 3, 5 and 3. Let's run the program and see whether we are getting 3, 5, 3 or not. You see 3, 5, 3. So what should be the output now? 4 plus 2, 6, 5 plus 3, 8, 6 plus 2, 8. Okay. So 6, 8, 8 should be the output. Let's run the program and see the output. Yeah, 688. So hope you understand this program. So by the end of this program, you'll come to know how to use the parsed and how to convert integer to string and string to integer. And one more thing, as I told you, the output should be string, not the integer, correct? So how do we do that? So here we are printing integer. Why? Because if you see sum, what is the data type of sum? Int. So how do we do that? How do we convert it to string? So system.out.println string.value of and just pass the integer. We have a method called value of, which is a static method present in the string class. So what this value of method does is it returns the string representation of the integer argument. So whenever we pass the string, it will return integer. This representation is exactly the one returned by integer.toString method of the argument. Okay. Now let's run the program and see the output. You should get 688 two times. Why? Because first is integer and the second one is the string. So hope you understand, right? So hope you understand how to sum two strings. Thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. At the same time, don't forget to give ratings to my course. Thank you.